Hello friends, this is Asif Momin. Today, we will learn how to draw different types of conics curves with the help of Directrix focus method. In this video, we will see how to draw an ellipse in a very easiest way. So before we start, we will see some basics of conics curves. And apart from ellipse, there are other two curves are also there. One is parabola and second is hyperbola. So these three types of curves are nothing but the conics, and we are going to see today how to draw this ellipse by directrix focus method. So directrix is nothing but a straight line, straight vertical line, you can see here. And let's say this directrix I am naming as line AB. So through any one point, any random one point, I'm going to draw a line that would be the normal to the directrix or perpendicular to the directrix. So that line is the axis line. So basically this directrix would be perpendicular to this axis line, and this axis line is nothing but the major axis for that ellipse curve. The intersection point of these two lines, I'm naming this point as C. Now it comes the fixed point F. Now in case of ellipse, how it is going to be, let's see. The vertex point is a point which is present on the curve and which is also present on the axis line. Now let's say any one point on the curve, I'm naming this point as P. Now when I take a ratio of P to F and P to C, that ratio is always constant. So this ratio, I'm naming this ratio as eccentricity E. This ratio is called eccentricity ratio. We know that like point P, vertex point V is also a point which comes on the curves. So when I replace this P by V, the eccentricity ratio becomes VF upon VC. Now this eccentricity is VF upon VC is called eccentricity, and this ratio will tell us which type of curve it is, whether it is ellipse, parabola or hyperbola. Now this value of E, whenever it is less than 1, so that time that curve is called ellipse. Whenever this ratio becomes 1 exactly, so that time the curve would be parabola. And whenever this eccentricity E becomes greater than 1, that time it becomes hyperbola. So friends, let's start how to draw an ellipse by directrix focus method. As this is a question to draw an ellipse, the distance between directrix and focus point we have been given, and eccentricity is also given. As we can see, eccentricity is 2/3, so it is a less than 1, so of course it is a ellipse. So we'll see how to draw an ellipse for such condition. Very first thing, we'll draw the directrix as a vertical line, and through any random point C, we will draw a perpendicular line to it. So that line will be called as axis line. Now from point C or from this directrix, we will measure 50 mm to mark a fixed point on axis line. So this is called fixed point F at a distance of 50 mm from the directrix. So guys, once we get fixed point F at a distance of 50 mm, we must locate point V, that is the vertex point of ellipse. For that, we are going to use eccentricity E ratio. E has been given 2/3, and this 2/3 is nothing but VF upon VC, right? So if I'm going to count total divisions, 2+3, 5 divisions. So 2 divisions I'm going to measure from F to get V, and 3 divisions from point C to get V, right? So total 5 divisions we need between point F and C. So I will be dividing this total 50 mm distance into 5 equal divisions. So at each 10 mm distance, I'm going to get the 4 points in between F and C. So 5 divisions will be there. Now measure 2 divisions from point F, you will get vertex point V as per our definition. Once you get point V, now draw a vertical line at point V. After getting vertical line at point V, you must take VF distance as a radius in your compass and cut the same distance from point V on that vertical line. So this distance I'm going to mark from point V on this vertical line itself, so that I'll get this point as E point. So in such a way that VF is equal to VE, right? So by cutting an arc, you'll get point E. Now the next process would be draw a line joining C to E and extend that line further on right hand side. Now once it is done, we must get particular intermediate points through which we can draw and curve. We'll divide this line further into particular divisions. So beyond point V, I'll take random distance in compass and cut an arc beyond point V itself. We already have 10 mm distance arc, 10 mm distance mark beyond point V. So we will continue with that only. We'll take 10 mm in compass and we'll continue marking on that axis line itself beyond point F as well. You can take these number of points as 7, 8, 9. It depends. Once it is done, name all these points like 1, 2, 3, up to how many points you have taken. You can take either 7 points as well or you can take 9 points as well. So this is what I have taken, 8 number of points on the axis line. Now through each and every point, draw a vertical line which will be cutting that slanted line above. Wherever this slanted line is being cut by these vertical lines, name those points as 1', 2', 3', up to 8' respectively. Now to get intermediate points to draw an ellipse curve, we must take 1.1 to 0.1' distance as a radius in the compass and from point F as in center, cut this arc on line 1', above and below. Radius 1', center from point F on a line 1', 1'. So this distance we are going to take in compass 1', 1', and that distance we are going to keep point F as center and we'll cut this distance arc on 1' above and below both sides. I'm repeating again, we are taking 1', 1' as a radius and by keeping point F as a center, we'll cut this distance 1', 1' on a line, on that line itself, above and below. Two points above and below on line 1', 1'. Similarly, now you will be taking distance 2', 2' as a radius and point F as in center, cut the distance on the same line itself. 2', 2' as a radius from point F as in center, cut that distance on same line 2', 2'. So it will come exactly at this point. Later on, you will be taking the next point as 3', 3', and this distance 3', 3' in compass, you will be cutting an arc from point F on the line 3', 3' above and below. So again you will get two points above and below. Like that you can continue. You will be taking next time 4' to 4' distance in compass, and this distance you are going to cut from point F on the same line 4', 4' above and below. Continue this procedure. When you come to this point 7, you are getting these two points. You have to continue till you get only one point that is on axis line. So when I take distance 8 to 8' in compass and point from point F and cut an arc, it is coming exactly on axis line. So it is not reachable till that vertical line at point 8. So it is cutting only an axis point. So this point would become second vertex point V dash or point V2. Now once you get all these intermediate points, draw a curve passing through all these points. So this smooth curve passing through all these intermediate points is called an ellipse. Once you draw ellipse, now it is time to draw a normal and tangent to the curve through any point lying on the curve. So you can take any one random point on the curve. I have taken this is a point where I am supposed to draw a normal line and tangent line to the curve. So from this point, do one thing, draw a line connecting this point F. Once you connect this point with point F, draw another line which would be exactly perpendicular to this previous line itself. So the angle between these two lines must be 90 degree. Now once you do complete this line, you should check that where that line is cutting the directrix. And from this point, draw another line joining the original point itself. So that line will become a tangent line. See, when you draw a perpendicular line to it, the new line will become a normal line. So this is an ellipse, and this is the easiest way to draw an ellipse by directrix focus method. So guys, that's all from my side today. I will be back with more videos on engineering drawing. So then have a great day and keep practicing engineering drawing. Thank you.